Safety, which is going to consist of a three-man team and then a two-man team. We'll just do a three-person rotation. Just don't get split off. You guys obviously know we've been diving together for some time, but sometimes you get like a little crazy because you see something cool, you see a big fish, and you just kind of go off, communicate with each other. God gave us that gift, so let's use it. Let's just be safe out there, man. We got to come back home to our family, our loved ones waiting for us back on shore. So that's for sure.
Sharks, goliath groupers, strong currents, and boat traffic are some of the variables that you could find while diving the wrecks. The wrecks could hold a lot of fish, but at the same time, they could just be an empty box. It's better for you to dive the wrecks with a good, trustable buddy that could spot you and you could spot him, and also a good captain that could spot you from the boat in case there's an emergency, or in case you actually catch a good, decent-sized fish, the captain will come to you and assist you. Your buddy will be there to assist you. Never ever dive a wreck by yourself. That's the worst thing you can do. Hey guys, I'm Jose, and I'm here at Spearfishing. I brought Andrew some cell phone cases that I'm gonna drop off, and he's got no idea that we'll be interviewing him for Spearheads. So let's have a chat with him. Hey buddy. What's up, dude?
What's up, man?
Jose.
How you been, man?
Pretty good, man. What's up?
Awesome, buddy. Doing good. Just brought you the some cases.
Oh, sweet. Sweet. Thanks, man. Yeah. A couple people have been asking about them, so thanks, man. Appreciate it.
Good to hear, man.
How's everything?
Good, man. Good. Doing well. Mm-hmm. You know, I know that I came unannounced.
Okay.
But I wanted to give you a surprise because you have been selected to speak about safety since you are a certified FII instructor.
All right, man, that's cool. Safety is actually a really important topic, especially when it comes to any kind of breath hold activity underwater. Yeah, dude, let's talk about it. Yeah, as I'm sure, obviously, you know, you're one of our head camera guys in the show. The safety is a big part of it. We always do a briefing before we go out on one buddy up, one buddy down. And guys, it can get pretty tricky out there. Jose knows this firsthand. If you're a camera guy, who's got your back? You know, so every diver going down has to have a properly trained buddy on the surface waiting for them just in case of any kind of tricky, hairy scenario, loss of motor control, blackout occurs, boom, you're right there. It's very important. Another thing you might have just heard me say, properly trained buddy.
Correct.
So if I'm diving, and someone who has never taken a course has no idea what to do, should I really trust what's going on there? Not, you know, it gets a little hairy, a little tricky.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, guys, if you're not properly trained in freediving safety, look into it. FII has great courses available, and it's just really important because now I'm not going to dive with someone who's not properly trained because I got their back, but dude, who's got my back?
Right.
You get me? And that's when it gets a little hairy, a little tricky. So yeah, I always dive with a buddy, and when I mean dive with a buddy, I don't mean like, hey Jose, mm-hmm. I'm diving with you, dude. I'm gonna go check out this rock. See you later. You know, no, you gotta always stay on top of each other. Communicate. Like that one time we were out there,
mm-hmm.
and I think you were filming me. I think dropping down on a wreck, and you're like, Andrew, I'm gonna drop down with you, and we let our safeties know on the surface we're gonna be down there doing some filming. We always talk. We always communicate.
Correct.
So
not only that, but I mean, we're not the only predators out there, you know. I mean,
it's true.
I mean, we got sharks. We got just about everything out there. I mean, yes, we're predators, but there's other things that are stronger than us. You know,
other variables for sure. Boat traffic, sharks, like he said,
mm-hmm.
All kinds of crap, dude. You're out there. You're part of the ecosystem. You're part of what's going on out there.
And technology, ecosystem, and technology. Part of the technology because all the boats. I mean, how many accidents have you heard of?
A lot.
Divers,
unfortunately.
You know, right.
Unfortunately. But yeah, I mean, so you just gotta be on top of things. From a safety standpoint, the best thing I can tell our viewers out there, always dive with a properly trained buddy. Get properly trained if you're not properly trained. And don't separate from each other. Stay on top of each other. Buddy separation is one of the worst things you can do. No fish, no freaking lobster is worth your life, guys, period.
It's December 31st, the last day of grouper season here on the east coast of Florida. I actually went out with a couple of buddies of mine and we left the marina at about 7:30 and we managed some fish, but pretty much my last spot, we had arrived there at about 11 a.m. so it was fairly early.
when I was actually heading back to the boat after scanning a reef, which I didn't think it held much fish. As I was getting closer to the boat, I spot in the bottom a red grouper that was making its way to coral head. I followed the grouper, and he actually went inside the coral head. I don't know what made me look back, but as I looked back, I just found another. I saw a 29-inch black grouper who swam into another coral head. Both coral heads were about 20 feet from each other. Yeah, they were about 20 feet from each other, and both groupers are inside the rocks, so they caved in. Then all of a sudden, this huge hogfish, about 22 inches and a half, swims in, you know, all over the coral head just to check out the groupers. It's the last day of grouper, and I'm thinking to myself, do I shoot the hog? But if I shoot the hog, I'm, you know, risking losing the black grouper. Not worry about the red, I know the red's gonna stay there. So, you know, I just take a second to think, and then the hog pretty much goes away. As the hog leaves, the black grouper comes out, and I descend to the bottom, and, you know, swim straight to the coral head, and then just do a peekaboo on the black grouper. I swim straight to the coral head, pop my gun on my head, right on top of the coral head, and there was the black looking at me, and that's when I shot him right in his back, through the back, right through the spine. It was a pretty clean kill, and a lot of good meat. Got the grouper back to the boat. I told the guys, this spot is full of fish. As one of my buddies is getting dressed up, I go to the other rock that was 20 feet away from the black grouper rock, and I dive to the bottom, and there is the red grouper waiting for me right outside the rock. I shoot it, but the shot, you know, I shot it on the center of the body, but it was just a little bit too high, so the grouper just went ballistic, and he broke loose from the shaft. He went back into the rock. I descended back to the bottom once again, got a sight on the red grouper, and shot him. Honestly, right after that, it caught a nice, decent size hog as well. So it was a pretty good ending to grouper season. I mean, both pretty good sized fish with a lot of meat. Pretty much, they fed the whole entire family. So it was a pretty good ending to the season. Can't wait until the next season.
We could be so close, like brown.